Fred Murphy. I'm the Program Director of the MSc in International Accounting and Business, or as we refer to it in business school, the MIAB program. And this is a new program. This is its very second year of running. So we have one graduated cohort. And so the program is a mix of business and accounting modules. Half of the credits are business modules, half of the credits are accounting modules. And I'm delighted to be joined this morning by one of the graduates from our first cohort, Anne Mary George. So Anne Mary graduated from the program in 2020 and is currently working in a professional services firm in Dublin, BDO. So without further ado, I'm going to find out a little bit more about Anne and her perspectives and participation on the program. So I suppose the first thing that a lot of people might be interested in is why did you select this particular master's program?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Fred, for this opportunity. For me, I had a desire within myself to go abroad and have my further education. So I had a research across the globe and I landed up in Ireland, finding out that there is a higher chance of employability after a master's degree. And then I researched on different universities and I found that Dublin Business School is one of the best universities. Business school, one of the best business schools in Ireland, with having more than 95% employability rate. So as any other person, I too had the dream of getting employed after my master's program. And then I landed, I decided the DCU is my choice for my further education. And then looking into different courses, I already have a business background, but I don't have a solid accounting background, but I cannot pursue a master's in accounting, but what I can do is to get a master's in both accounting and business, the blended learning of business and accounting modules. So MIAB was the perfect choice for me as I would get a chance to deal with accounting subjects and the business skills. So I can get a technical expertise in accounting modules and also to develop my competency within the business. So that would help me to take decisions, to know about the wider aspects of business. So that made me to choose MIAB program. And the most motivating factor was the 6 exemptions that I would get to pursue my ACCA degree and to become a certified chartered accountant. And the program also gives us a choice to decide upon whether to go move to ACA, getting 3 exemptions in CAP 1, and to either move to ACA or ACCA. So I felt like it is giving me a wider choice to either move to the accounting sector, the audit sector, or even the business sector. And the analytical module within the program will also give me a chance to move into that way too. So all these motivating factor gave me this program to be more interested.
That's great. And then I suppose when you embarked on the program, it was probably a new experience coming to a new country, a new university, a new type of program. Can you tell us a little bit about your experience on the program and how that worked for you?
The program, as I already said, it has got equal importance for accounting modules and business modules. For me, the program was quite challenging. It was quite tough in the beginning to have the transition from what type of education that I had previously and the type of education that is being followed here in DCU. The accounting modules is actually giving you the technical knowledge, the knowledge that you require in the future workplace, and the business modules will help you to develop that competency that you require in the business field, in the diverse business section. So it will give you an overview about the different industries, and most importantly, the 2 modules, the practicum applied research, that would give you a kind of a real experience working with the client. To understand the different, maybe it might be the risk within the business, or it might be the future prospects within the business, the prospective clients. So the DCU will be able to support you in finding out the client and working with the client for a couple of months towards the end of the program. So that gives you a real experience about the real business happening in the world at that time. And another module that gave me a good experience, the NGM, a next generation management module, that gave me a wider perspective about business, society, the digital thing, the research, and also most importantly, my career and personal development. So the module actually tailored me to understand where the students' shortcomings or students' weakness are, and help us to focus on the positives and move towards the better career for the future. So overall, the program gave me a good experience. It's quite challenging, but it was actually walking to the top of a mountain. And after I completed the program, I was feeling like, okay, I achieved something. And it's not impossible, actually. It's possible, but you should have that real commitment, real hardworking, and you should have that real time management skill to tackle the program towards the end.
Okay, and now that you've successfully completed the program and you're based in BDO, can you talk to us a little bit about your current role and what that entails?
Yeah, sure. Currently, I'm working as a trainee auditor within BDO Ireland. It's a professional servicing firm. I joined in BDO in November 23rd, 2020. My role is actually to work as an external auditor to assist in the auditing work, and we deal with a diverse set of clients from different industries. So every day is a learning experience for me. Like for 1 week, if I work with one of the clients from a hotel industry, the next week would be from the construction, next week would be from the food industry. So every day is a learning experience. And within 3 years, I look forward in completing my professional experience required to gain the ACCA membership, as well as to complete the rest of the exams within this 3 years of time coming forward.
Okay, so the learning is continuing in both the accounting.
Yes, it's continuing.
IB is following you into the workplace.
Sure.
And obviously you completed the program during a pandemic.
Yeah.
You commenced employment during a pandemic, and that obviously added another layer to your experiences. So can you tell us a little bit maybe about how DCU supported you as you completed the program and as you navigated the recruitment processes as well, obviously with the pandemic in the background?
Yeah, sure. For me, actually, I didn't have that idea about on applying for jobs from the commencement of the course. I really thought that it's possible for you to apply for jobs only after completing the course. But after landing in DCU, after I started the course within MIAB, I realized, oh, there is the possibility for applying jobs from the first day. The DCU career fair that happened in the beginning of the year gave me that idea about the wide employers in Ireland, that there is a chance of employability for accounting graduates in 2020. So I started to apply for the jobs. And the first support that I received from DCU was in terms of tailoring my CV. I had appointment with the DCU Career Services a couple of times, and they helped me to tailor my CV in such a way that it would be attractive for the employers. And I still believe if I had gone with the CV that I had before, I wouldn't have been chosen by any of the companies. I had got a couple of interviews and a couple of assessment centers throughout the year. So it was actually balancing the workload from DCU and also all the recruitment process at the same time. And I was fortunate enough to get into a company, a big business in Ireland, which gave me an offer by the end of December 2020, and I was supposed to start in September 2021. But unfortunately, due to the pandemic, the offer was freezed. But all through the recruitment process, I got a good bunch of support from the DCU in terms of even faculties from different cohorts were ready to help me in preparing for my interview. It was in the aviation sector, so I still remember the program director of the aviation department. She gave me a good set of knowledge and understanding about the aviation sector while I prepared for the interview. And the DCU career advisors gave me an understanding about how I should be in the assessment center, how I should be in the interview, and all inputs were from the services within DCU. And later on, since the offer was freezed, after completing the course, I restarted the application process. I restarted applying for the jobs. And the way how DCU supported in that way, like for all the listeners listening to me right now, I can tell you something from my experience. Even after you graduate from DCU, you can get the services and help and support from DCU, whichever is possible from their side. As an international student, I received good support and help for finding the job from the international, the services from international office and also from the DCU career advisors later on.
That's really positive. And then I suppose just making that transition then, so you went through the recruitment, you started in your new role and so on. How do you feel you can apply the knowledge and skills and so on that you developed during the course of the IAB program to your current role?
So I'm working as a trainee auditor. So actually I'm dealing with business, but at the same time I'm applying my accounting knowledge. So from the accounting modules, I received the knowledge that is required to do the work that I'm currently doing, and also to get the exemptions. So that is actually really giving me a future hope. Okay, I can complete the ACCA membership within 3 years of time. Within the business modules, that really helps me being in business is the NGM, the Next Generation Management Module. At least some of you might have already heard about the module. So it gives you an understanding about the digital research, business, and career and personal development. So it's actually a whole bunch of learning throughout the year that caters you as a good person. Maybe I should say I took around 1 year to understand how to manage time properly. It took around 6 months to understand how I should tackle my exams. It took around one whole year to understand how better my communication could be possible. So in every way, the program module is helping me. And one thing that comes to my mind suddenly is like, now we have, it's working remotely from home. There's a good pressure within the workplace, like what we're doing, we have to complete within a time frame. But when I look back the previous 1 year in GCU, like the 12 months in GCU, I feel like that was quite difficult than what I'm doing now. That's only because of the experience that I got from GCU, the way how the things were structured. So for all the listeners, you would be able to maybe mold yourself being in GCU 1 year to a better workplace, to a better employee for the future, where you will be able to communicate properly, where you'll be able to critically think, where you'll be able to manage your time and always be resilient. And all the, especially the pandemic helped me to be more resilient than before.
I think that's good advice for all of us, Anne. And what's your advice for anybody who might be considering doing the course, or maybe for anybody who has already decided they're going to opt into the course? So any sort of top tips maybe?
Sure. One thing that I can share about is like you'll get a wider choice to move either to the accounting stream or to the business field. And for those who are not having a background in accounting and business, you can feel really happy to join the course because it will be getting you to start from the scratch, to start from the basic concepts of accounting. So it will not be a problem for you to understand the concepts, or it's not mandatory that you should have prior knowledge in accounting skills, accounting subjects. And the exemptions that you would receive from this is really helpful for you to complete the whole set of 13 exams in ACCA or the CAP 1. Also for those, like suppose for me in my career path, I had joined an auditing firm and I will be completing my full experience within 3 years. So since I had gone for the master's program, I have a good set of knowledge from accounting and business that would help me to put into my workplace, so that many of my queries are just tackled by myself. I don't want to get help from seniors to understanding even the terms, because there are people who move into the accounting field, think about the job prospects and future career development even after an engineering course, or maybe after some mechanical or civil engineering. For them, it's quite difficult to understand the terms to start from beginning. But this course, this master's degree, will help you to have a wider understanding about business and accounting prospects. So it would be a good choice. And then the course is quite challenging, but I should say there are people who have completed the course and there are people who are still doing the course. So it's not impossible for you to tackle it. It is possible for you. But only thing is, like, you have to keep up that commitment and hard working from the day one, and to give good time for your accounting modules, because it's the exams are not easy, because there is a standard kept by the university. So the standard is really high. It would be a transition from what you have done previously, especially for those who are doing undergraduate degree, or even if you have done some master's degree in some other countries, the standard kept in GCU is really high. So you should be able to tackle the exams. So keep on practicing from day one. Never postpone things for tomorrow. It's quite challenging. That's advice.
I think that's really good advice. And just one thing I suppose I want to just pick out from what you said there is that you have a 3-year training program with the accounting firm and to gain admittance to the ACCA Professional Accounting Body. And just to highlight, I suppose, if you had joined as a trainee in an accounting firm or business firm, undertaking your exams and so on, your training contract would likely have been 4 years. So by spending 1 year in DCU, you're not actually adding to your overall timeline. So that's important, I suppose, to realize that as well. And I'm going to ask you one more question, Anne. Just how are you finding working from home? Obviously, you're the first set of graduates in DCU who are starting employment, working from home and having completed your program from home. So just want to find generally if you have any advice, maybe or insights that that might be helpful to our graduates of 2021 to that end, or any other challenges maybe that you could give some insight in terms of dealing with them.
Working from home it's really challenging. Like as all of you know, it's really difficult in one way, but in some ways it's quite good. But for me, since I had that experience working from, like I did my exams, the final exams for DCU from my home, from this desk. I did my the last semester, few of the last months from this setup. So that had helped me actually to have the change. For I had heard from my seniors that it was really, really difficult for them to move from office to home. But for me, it was from home to home, so it was not that difficult for me. But the challenge that I face now is the lack of social interaction. It's really a difficult situation without having that social interaction with others. So I think that would be the challenge for even for the new graduates that's coming up. So make sure that you have good communication with all other peer, all of the members in the group, or maybe with the faculties, to have that communication, to have the social element. So I believe that we should have some kind of activities maybe, or maybe some engagements to make sure that that social interaction is still going on, and it should continue even after your studies to have that good relationship with people.
Okay, that's really good, really important advice, I think, not just for the students, but maybe something that we need to take on board as well. So I think that's it, and that has been really, really helpful and really, really insightful. And I suppose as a graduate of the first cohort and a graduate who completed the programme during a pandemic and started your first role during a pandemic, it's been really good to get your thoughts on